Welcome back, folks. I have a good heartbreak battle for you. So I'm playing the tier 7 Chinese light tank, the WZ-131. This is a pretty good light tank, and I had it for a long time, because it's kind of a hybrid between a light tank and a medium tank. It could carry an 85mm or a 100mm gun, so it's like a medium tank, but it's fast and mobile, and has a lot of camouflage rating, so you can play this thing like a light tank, or you can wolfpack it with other mediums. But I don't do this vehicle justice, because usually when I play light tanks, I play it super passively. So I like to passive scout rather than active scout. And that's because I'm a coward. So I don't do this vehicle justice. But as you can see, I have camouflage nets, binoculars, and vents. Whereas active scouts usually have something like coded optics, vents, and maybe vertical stabilizer or gun rammer. So, yep, difference in scouting techniques, but by starting with passive scouts, I liked it. Yeah, I'm a coward. So here you can see I'm doing the passive scout, trying to see all the enemies. And this match is not that favorable, only 37% chance to win. So should be a little bit more cautious, take my time, spot the enemies and shoot them if I can. So be patient, and the middle is not covered, as you can see right now. So if any other light tanks go for our artillery, it's a bad sign. So I should go and help out when that time comes. But take my time, do the passive scout, let the binoculars and camouflage net work. So we're losing the hill as well as the valley. Oh, here is the scorpion, and this vehicle doesn't have the health like any other light tanks, so don't take a hit. And the armor is troll-ish, it's not really that troll, so you could bounce a few shots with extreme angles of the turret. So the turret is rounded, but it's not as thick as the medium tanks, so it's not as thick as a Type 59, so do not expect it to bounce a lot of shots, and you can easily penetrate if it hits directly onto the center of the turret, so don't get hit. Here you can see we're getting flanked. Valley is almost lost. Have to go counter this light tank right here. Alright, the other WZ-131 is down, so good news. So I'm thinking about taking pot shots at the heavy tanks coming up the valley, but I spotted AMX ELC. So get rid of him. And I suck at aiming, so whoops. I do not have gun rammer, I do not have vertical stabilizer or enhanced gun lane drive, so I'm playing vehicles like super passively, so that's my cowardice in effect. But it's like how I play other light tanks, like the T-71 or AMX 1375. I play it super passively because I'm a coward when playing light tanks. So here is a scorpion. So we're going to circle strafe him. He has only 18 degrees of turret traverse, so it's pretty slow. He does not notice that I'm coming around. So his turret traverse is super slow, easily circle strafe, and he is toast. Nice. So try to push up to spot a little bit more. Now here is where I made my only mistake, in my opinion, of this match, which is I should have go down the hill and not try to circle strafe this guy, but whoops, took a hit, took a very big hit, like 60% of my health. Ugh, god, so disgusting. But took care of the scorpions with a big gun, so I can easily outspot these guy. Ugh, Cromwell. So the armor is not that great. I get penetrated with the Cromwell's gun, which is a 76mm, I believe. So, ugh, yeah, not fair. So here is the AMX yet again. Now he has a 90mm, which does a lot of damage for me, so that's bad. But he is short, and he doesn't have that good of a, you know, gun arc, so easily pick him off. Now trying to go for this Unicom 112. So he is currently being occupied by AMX CDC, so he is not paying attention to me. That's good. So I'm going to circle strafe him or take pot shot. So two prong attack onto this guy. He has the armor against my shells, but I do have a lot more penetration than average tier 7s, so that's good. Why is the AMX circle strafing backwards? I mean, in this case, you should two-prong your opponents, so this way you can get flanking fire. So if one guy doesn't have the shot, the other guy will. But if you move to the same side, then he has a better focus on both of you. So, oh well, mistakes. So shoot the lower plate. There we go. Oh, high explosive loading. He has low health, so high explosive should kill him. Oh, do not want to get hit by his 122. Oh, he doesn't focus me. Okay, pick him off. And I'm by myself now. Whoopee, so Kalabanov's medal in the works. So a bunch of heavy tanks are coming this way, including a STA-2, a T-32, and likely a KV-85 based on the speed. So I'm going to go to get a better vantage point. So in this situation, your advantage is playing light tanks. So light tanks have better view range, better camouflage rating. So what you should do is use that to the maximum advantage of your winning the battle. So you should play in open fields where you have better view range to outspot your enemies, and do not get into close range battles. So I spotted the STA-2 and the KV-85. Easily pick off the STA. No turret armor, so alright. Bounce a shot or dodge a shot. So keep wiggling, keep moving, throw off the artillery shot. There he is. So keep wiggling, keep dancing, break dancing. So be sure to draw off shots. The KV-85 does not move. Take a peek at the T-32 and let's try to kill this AV-5. So he is side scraping, but turret is exposed. I loaded gold because I want to win. And Kalabanov's medal is in the works on the line. So keep moving, dodge another artillery shot. T-32 is at full health, so retreat. Get your advantage. He is hauled down on a hill, so it's not likely that you're going to win the trading battle with artillery in play. So right now I thought to myself, I'm faster, I'm going for artillery, knock him out, so I have an even chance against heavy tanks with slow speed and no view range. So there's the artillery. He missed. Good. So do not ram. Ramming will lose you health, which you do need. So circle strafe him, easily pick him off, alright. And let's keep moving. The T-32 is coming, I know it, because he has a lot of health. He is relatively fast, 35 kilometers per hour, top speed. So have to get out of here. I took a look with XVM right now, and saw that the KV-2 has low health, around 80-ish. So there's the T-32, so going for the KV-2, but the only benefits of the KV-2 is close range combat and high alpha. So you can just negate that with open field battles, and you can outspot him because his view range is super crap. So Russian heavy tank, crap view range. So use your view range to outspot the enemy. So I'm trying to see where this KV-2 is. He was last spotted near our base, so he is not capping, so it's likely that he went backwards trying to kill me. So flank all the way around, be patient. I'm faster, I'm more keen-eyed, so I could outspot them. So do not get into a close range battle. If you do, circle strafe, outmaneuver, but let's not try to get into that just yet. So I have low health, I am one shot for both vehicles, be patient. But where is the KV-2? So he's not up here. Take a quicker peek, go into this bush. So be patient, use the binoculars and the camouflage net. I could easily outspot the KV-2 and the T-32. Where is the enemy? So what I'm afraid of right now is somebody popping behind the hill right in front of me, the small hill right in front of me, because I do not have direct line of sight, but there is the KV-2. So better view range, better camouflage, allows me to outspot him, easily pick him off. He did not spot me, so that's good. So back to the bush, keep spotting. It's likely the T-32 will come to investigate that area, maybe, so have to be a little bit patient. So be patient, patient. I have a vantage point right here. So I am at the high ground, as Obi-Wan says. Yep, I have the high ground, so I can easily outspot other people, but nobody's appearing right now, so I'm getting a little bit impatient. Oh, but there is the trigger of the base capture, so have to go reset. And this T-32 has 800 health, so it's about 4 shots. So it's a little bit rough. I'm a one-shot kill. He needs 4 rounds to kill. So have to play smart. There is a bush. I shouldn't have knocked over this tree, but oh well, he did not notice it. So that's his mistake. And punish him. Right. Pull back. Now I could pull back and shoot him through the bush without him spotting me, but there were a lot of hills right there, a lot of bumps and hilly terrain, so I cannot exactly get the tank's gun down because Chinese vehicles have crappy gun depression. So oh well, he is looking at me into this bush, so I was afraid of pulling the trigger because he would spot me when I fired the gun and he could easily pull the trigger himself and kill me. So pull back, change the position of the bush by a little bit, and this little bit will save my life. So he is not looking at the same bush. Gun's accuracy is crap. So did not reset, did not hit him, or actually I hit him but did not do anything about it, so basically did not hit him. Oh well, go back to the bush, change the position. Still looking at this bush for some reason, I don't know why. I was shooting at you from the other bush, so as you can see right here, I'm trying to shoot through the bush, and shooting through the bush will not get me spotted. But the gun depression does not help, and he is hauled down. He does not move. Alright, take a better aim. There you go, reset the cap. Good. Alright. Well, if he doesn't move, then I'm going to kill him if he doesn't move. So that's my advantage. And he doesn't shoot blindly into the bush, so that's good. Pull back into a different bush. He gets smart, so he pulls back into haul down position, using the hill as cover. Oh, crap. So no shot for me. I decide to flank around because he would easily kill me if I just run through the middle. He is hauled down, he is pointing his gun this way, so be a little bit more cautious. Right now my heart is pounding, so by myself, Calabano's medal on the line, and already got the Radley Walters. But be patient, so hopefully he is not pointing his gun this way, and I could go circle strafing him. Oh crap, I got spotted, damn it. So using the trench, some sort of cover, try to get a good shot onto him, or at least his cupola, to damage the periscopes, therefore resetting the cap. So taking a look at the time, not enough time. Oh crap, panicking right now, switching to high explosive, so trying to deal at least one damage to reset the cap. Do not want to get hit. It is hauled down, so I might bounce a shot from him. He might bounce a shot from me. Shit. What? I high explosive snapshot him, hit him, deal zero damage. Because freaking reasons, right? God damn it. It's 100mm high explosive. What the frick? Well, there you go, folks. Heartbreak. I cannot carry this team that much. But Radley Walters medal, Defender medal, Top Gun medal. So, very good outcome. Basically 1,500 XP-ish if it was normally, or 954 plus 600 or so. So, yeah. But hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.